We worked with Peat Wollaeger. He's the leading stencil artist in the Midwest. And he saw a train. When he saw it, he was like, that's a train. And he's kind of a train guy. So his signature eyes, you can see right behind me up here. His eyes are iconic for representing waking people up. With his art, he wants to awaken people. So he feels like a lot of people go through life just kind of, you know, looking at their iPhones or whatever, not really paying attention to their surroundings. And he wants to wake people up with his eyes. So that's what that the eye symbol is. But the trains, he's also, trains have been kind of a part of his work recently. So it's all very serendipitous, really.
Today, we are doing this beautiful mural with trains. Really cool.
What did you think of meeting Peat?
He was cool. Meeting Peat was really cool. When Peat came to Teen Arts Council, he took us outside and basically showed us the ground rules to spray painting. We had like a cardboard and we did eyes and smiles.
The projects like this are important to the community because it's hard to tell what holds our communities together anymore. And so something like this out here that is a part of everyone's life, whether they know it or not, they see it, they pass it, it makes an impression, either good or bad, on people. And so to get everyone out here together, working on it, concerned about what their community looks like, concerned about what sort of messages are being conveyed in and by their community, it's the kind of thing that I think we need to be more concerned about today.
I feel like this mural will impact the community because one, it's giving our Monon Trail and South Broad Ripple an opportunity to have identity. It's along the Monon Trail and it's a part of its history. So the artists here have really enveloped that and taken that on and really tried to promote that and also bring the community in to be able to make this happen.
People actually see the wall, they're stunned by it, it takes a minute, they turn around, they come back, they get off their bikes, they actually walk up to us and say, oh my gosh, this is so beautiful, thank you. And that's all they have to say, they leave. As an artist, as a person running a nonprofit, it's all you really want, is the opportunity.